goes Spies. Kano chases hard across. There's January Waits. Rokothoko. Muliaina there with him. Jane is further out, but they decide to take the middle channel. And away goes Muliaina. Looks for his support, finds it in the form of Richie McCaw. And now it's with Conrad Smith. Smith for the corner. Conrad Smith's in. Smith, and just have a look at it here.
You see, he went back looking for Rokothoko. Berger didn't go with him, and he just lit up, did Muliaina. McCaw, this time he looked for support early rather than take the tackle, and it was Conrad Smith who realised it was Victor Matfield, and he just went low and under him.
What an awful chase, too, of that kick from Ricky January. The kick wasn't good, but when you've got...
Right, Nonu tried to drop the kick in. I think he got it back. He did. Now he gives it off to Rokothoko. Rokothoko close. Ball has been picked up. And here's Nonu again. Nonu! Ma'anonu!
Involved on a number of occasions. Bit lucky there to get the ball back on a bounce of the Springbok shut down. Well, this is the other man involved an awful lot. Down the left-hand flank, Rokothoko and Nonu. They worked it over. Thorn on the pick. Nonu took it off him. Just a good low body position under
Nonu. 6 or 7 metres out from the line. All Blacks desperate for quick ball. They get a two. Now Wepu. Charging onto this goes Reed. Kieran Reed.
Haven't gone all game. Some great work through the middle. Donnelly, who's been prominent tonight. So in behind the advantage line again. Clearing the ball quickly. Muliaina. Quick ball again. See the line that Kieran Reed ran, picked out two guys, Spies and January, went straight through them. They didn't see him coming.
Yeah, Pierre Spies will be disappointed with that effort, and as will January and Kirshner for that.
And this will come back more cleanly as they go, and they reckon they've got it. Let's see what the referee says. Yes! Try scored.
Tony Woodcock, I think.
Tony Woodcock, well, he scored tries prior to this.
They've won the physical battle. They knew they needed to do that tonight. This man, Kieran Reed, has been one of many who've led the charge. Plenty of numbers in behind. Great body position.
Unstoppable All Blacks out there in that front.
Not tonight, Josephine. Puts it away, and the siren goes, and a dominant All Black performance is acknowledged by the big crowd. 32 points to 12. What an effort.
Well, I think the key word was intensity, and you brought it tonight.
Yeah, we certainly did, and we did it right from the start, which we knew we had to do. The Springboks are good at getting points up and then just, making us play catch-up. You know, we've experienced that in the past. But, I was pretty proud of the way the guys, they made really good decisions, and we built the pressure and took our chances, which you got to do.
Confidence, too, to run the ball out from your goal line on the first phase and then maybe take the kick if you needed to do that. But the confidence was there all over the park.
Yeah, it was, but it came about through good decisions. And you know, whether to kick or whether to carry, the guys looked at what was in front of them and, You can have a go if you're in your own half, as long as you look after the ball and do the little things right, and we did that for the most part.
It's obvious you've done a lot of work on the set pieces. The scrum very, very solid tonight, so that was a plus. And the line out, I'm not sure we've seen a better one.
No, and that comes down to hard work, and belief in yourselves. It's easy to sort of, it's a simple thing, yet you make it complicated. So we wanted to make sure we kept it simple and everyone doing their little jobs. Line out time, you got to lift, you got to jump right, you got to throw right, and you get that right, you win the ball, so that's what we did.
A superb first 40. I would imagine the message was much the same, and the increased the intensity. You knew they would come back. That was the only danger time.
Yeah, it was, and we did talk about that at halftime. That 10-minute spell, and we gave away a couple of penalties there, but the guys stuck at it, and we got down the right end of the field, and we sort of put the pressure straight back on them.
And this on the back of a few of these guys haven't played a hell of a lot of rugby lately.
No, a guy like Ma'anonu and Tom Donnelly, to name a couple, that haven't played a lot. They had pretty big games out there, so obviously done something right. But I think 1-15 did it all, and it made it easy for those guys. So
great history here at Eden Park, Richie. I think this is probably one of the best to preserve that legacy.
Yeah, well, hopefully it carries on for a bit longer yet.